Hi, and welcome to another awesome video by 365 Data Science, where we take interesting ideas related to data, technology, business, and careers, then turn them into unique and intriguing content for your enjoyment. So without delay, let's get started. Nowadays, it feels like every week another groundbreaking invention or idea is revealed. But how did we get here? In this video, we're going to look at the evolution of technology from the very beginning. We'll go through some of the most influential devices and concepts that have led us to this techno-fueled world we live in today. Our time travel journey starts pretty much when we did. Before selfies, trolling, open world gaming, and cheesy infographic videos, way back in 35,000 BCE, with the first recorded example of counting. It all began with a simple tally on a bone, the Lebombo bone. Talk about upcycling. More conveniently, papyrus paper was invented in 3000 BCE for recording and the abacus in 2300 BCE for sums. These had evolutions of their own for the next couple of millennia, around up to 100 CE, where they reached a state how we know them today. This was also the time Hindu-Arabic numerals were developed, not the first characterized numbers, but ones which allow complex mathematics. Jumping to the second millennia, we have the development of the torquetum, a complex analog computer used to measure astronomical coordinates and is the basis for all modern astronomical instruments today. The torquetum was the first device used for the observation of Halley's Comet. Equally terrifying and amazing, in 1206 came one of the first examples of the concept of automation with Al-Jazari's programmable automata, which helped to fuel the ideas of mechanical humans and artificial intelligence. Recently, evidence was discovered showing that the first mechanical calculator was conceived in 1502 by none other than Leonardo da Vinci, who apparently invented everything. However, nothing came of it, and after a few manual calculation systems, the first mechanical calculator was realized as Pascal's calculator in 1642. Shortly after that, we got the binary system. But it wasn't until the 1800s that the technology was advanced enough to take advantage of it. Starting with the Jacquard loom, which used punch cards to automatically weave designs, then leading to Babbage's concept of the difference engine and later the analytical engine. Unfortunately, these last two projects weren't actualized due to funding, but that did not stop the world's first computer programmer, Ada Lovelace, from seeing how they could work and writing the first ever algorithm. Then, we literally captured lightning in a bottle and harnessed electricity. We performed the census with a tabulating machine for the first time. The triode was invented, which was essential for the development of television and radio. We came up with the idea of a thinking machine, the first ever robot in the sci-fi film Metropolis, and the Turing machine was conceptualized. All this played a huge part in the creation of the first ever electric computer in 1939, the Atanasoff-Berry computer. Work on the Atanasoff-Berry was discontinued due to World War II, but other computers built for the war effort, like the Colossus and Zeus Z3, were developed. During the war, a model for computational neural networks was created. And after the war had ended, we got the ENIAC, the grandfather of digital computing, the UNIVAC for business and government, the Transistor, the first thinking machines in the SNARK and the IBM 701. This was the first computer that displayed AI capabilities as it learned to play checkers. The 50s saw another step forward in machine learning with the Logic Theorist, a program designed to mimic the grammar skills of a human and dubbed the first AI program. This decade also sees the integrated circuit, which in the 60s was starting to be used in digital computers. This gives us the first ever mini computer, the PDP-1, which in turn creates the need for the mouse and graphical user interface. We also get Eliza, the first ever chatbot. The end of the 60s saw programmable calculators, supercomputers, operating systems, and the introduction of ARPANET, the internet's humbler and less complex older sibling. And of course, the Apollo guidance computer. The 1970s saw these technologies become commercial, and with that came a flood of new developments. The Honeywell 316, Canon Pocketronic, the first DRAM and microprocessors, the iconic floppy disk, the first humanoid robot, and the first commercially available microcomputer. The decade saw plenty of improvements to the technology, including Microsoft's first programming language and IBM's and Apple's original entries into desktop computing. The end of the 70s saw the first automated vehicle, the Stanford Cart, and led us into the 80s, where technology was quickly getting smaller, cheaper, and more powerful. We also find the development of backpropagation and the CD-ROM. During this time, tech is becoming so compact that the Galvalan SC is marketed as a laptop computer. AI is also making leaps and bounds with the CYC, a project aiming to build a knowledge base of basic concepts, rules of thumb, and common sense to assist AI applications to perform human-like thinking. In the following 5 years, we get handheld computers, AI that teaches itself to speak, the first versions of Windows and Excel, plenty of supercomputers, laptops, desktops, processors, and in 1989, we get the World Wide Web. The web and some big leaps in processing power in the early 90s brought PCs into the realm of entertainment devices. This decade introduced us to PC gaming, DVDs, internet browsers. We got some of the first mobile phone devices from Nokia to fit in our hands, and supercomputers that are now able to beat human master chess champions with Deep Blue. And let's not forget Skynet. I mean, Google. For the next decade, we see the development of various computers, hard drives, robots, processors, and the still-in-use USB. Speaking of speed, in 2002, we got the first commercial maglev, short for magnetic levitation train. The world is also introduced to YouTube, and the innate human need for on-demand cat videos was satisfied. With the huge growth and commercialization of technology in the last decade or two, data is everywhere. That's why, in 2005, the term big data is coined. Apple shows its power in the tech field with the release of the MacBook Pro, while the iPhone brings smartphones to the mainstream. In the late 2000s, IBM shows off its dominance in the realm of supercomputers by having the fastest in the world with Blue Gene, then bettering it themselves with Roadrunner. Blockchain arrives in force in 2008 to shake up the financial sector. China and Japan start to push back IBM in a battle for who has the most powerful supercomputer, with the Tiane and K computer respectively. This leads to some of the biggest jumps in computing power. We also see another show of AI's growth with Siri and Watson, who wins Jeopardy against human opponents. And it's not just on Earth where things are getting more advanced, with the Mars rover showing the rest of the universe what we're capable of. To exemplify how far we've come to this point, in 2012 and 13, we have supercomputers that reach exascale speed. And on our wrists, we have computational devices millions of times faster than the computers that sent a rocket to the moon. And did I mention now that our rockets have the capability to land themselves, with a lot more computing power than a watch, mind you. By 2016, we've officially reached sci-fi territory, with self-aware Sophia, 3D-printed prosthetic limbs, and realistic virtual reality. At this point, we're also looking at molecular computing, because humanity loves making small tech, especially things like almost paper-thin laptops with incredibly fast processors and cancer-fighting nanobots. And because we also like to show off, we have the fastest supercomputer at 200 petaflops with Summit. New grounds of travel and AI combined with the Model S and Atlas, who puts many of us to shame with his precision parkour. We really are in amazing times. But where do you think we'll be heading next? What will be the next big thing? Are we maybe going too fast? Our ancestors had much more time to process and learn from new developments. We'd like to open up a discussion in the comments and get your thoughts on future technology. And of course, if you enjoyed this video and would like to see more, like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell.